Hi, this is Andrei Osachuk. I welcome you to another training on Analysis Workspace and Adobe Analytics. Today I'm going to show you a few tips. The first one is how to make a copy of somebody's segment. Then I will show you how to find hidden segments in Calculated Metric Builder UI. And finally, I will show you a tip how you can make a page view metric with Attribution Model, which is not possible by default, by design. So let's start with the first scenario. Why you may want to make a copy of somebody's segment. If you look at what I have in the segments, my top five segments are shown as you see them on the left. And let's have a look at the first segment, which is purchasers. This segment is one of the templates or one of those that were inherited by my account. And we can see that this will return all visitors who have ever placed an order on our site when we triggered a purchase event or order metric, which is out of the box metric. And the challenge here, or let's say my concern here, is that I don't think that the purchasers is the right name for this metric. And I also may want to add some additional comments so that it will be clear for myself and for those I will be sharing my project with or this segment with what this segment is about. So why I think that this is not the accurate name for this segment, because this would mean that every person who came to my site and placed an order has to pay for that order. However, it's not always the case. It's possible to go through the checkout flow, place an order, but then it's up to the customer whether to pay or not to pay for it. Because if on your site there are different payment options and one of them allows the customer to either pay for the order offline or pay for the order not at the time when the person goes through the checkout process, but let's say afterwards. In other words, if your site supports deferred payment options, then this is the case. This is when this purchaser's segment will not return the accurate data. So, and this is why I want to rename this segment. I want to name it like those who placed an order, but obviously not those who purchased something, because purchasers for me personally is somebody who paid for something on my site when I really know that I sold a product or service. And since I'm not an administrator, what I can do in this case, I can make a copy. How I can make a copy of the segment? If you go to components and segments, you won't find the segment there because it's not your segment. It's not the segment that was shared with you, because this is, as you see, and the icon is referring to kind of a template segment or the segment that was created in, let's say, a legacy version of Adobe Analytics. I don't really know how it's called. But it's very common to see such segments in your segments menu. And what you can do, you can actually create a freeform table, move this segment to metrics, and then you just need to right-click on the segment and select Create Segment from Selection. And this will open the segment builder, and you can very easy to update the segment the way you want. And it will be now your own segment that you will just save. So imagine that this wasn't so, let's say, simple segment, but this was quite big segment in terms of how many definitions or components were grouped together under definition area. And this is why it's very simple to create a copy using this scenario. Now you can rename it, now you can add description the way you want, and this segment will immediately become available for you. So let's call it visitors who placed an order. Okay, so now I will have this segment, and I will be the author of this segment. And now I want to show you how you can find this segment. So in most of the cases, if you work with the report suites, you will see this segment on the top because you have just created this segment. However, as you can see, I do not see it under the segments. Why it's happening? Because I currently work with the so-called virtual report suites. And maybe this is something that is exactly how you work with Adobe Analytics. Your administrators may not give you access to report suites, but they may give you access to virtual report suites. And when you work with the virtual report suites, the segment menu, actually it's a metrics menu as well, they work slightly differently. And let's look for the segment that I have created. So it's visitors, and we already can see that it's not in the list after applying a filter. However, what you can see here is this Show All Components button. And this is one of the tips that I wanted to show you today, that if you can't find your segment, but you see such a button, this means that you work with a virtual report suite, and to find your segment, you need to click on this button. So let's do this. And now we can see other segments that include the segment that I have created just a moment ago. So I will just add it to my table, and using this mechanic, you can create a copy of your segment and then find the segment in the menu. What else I wanted to show you today? Show you how you can find what I call hidden segments in Calculated Metric Builder. So let's imagine that now I want to create a new metric with the segment that we see, and I will go to the Metric Builder. However, take a look at my left rail menu. I do not have segments group at all. So how can I use segments? So for example, let's imagine that I want to have a look at how many visits I had on my site by those who at least placed one order. So I had to find that segment, but I can't see it here. And this is very confusing because you basically can't find your own segments. So what to do in this case? The tip is you can use this search field and apply a filter that will be called segments. When you apply this, you will have this button, Show All Components. And now we can find the segment that I created a moment ago. So this is a very powerful tip for you. So if you are confused why you can't see your segments, this is the way how you can find them in the Metric Builder. I won't save this calculated metric, just wanted to show you this method. And now tip number three, or last tip for this small video training, is how you can apply an attribution model to a page view metric. So let's have a look at, again, the metric builder. And I will add a few out-of-the-box metrics, page views and visits. And if you click on the gear icon, you can see that the attribution is grayed out, so you can't use this. And you can see that non-default attribution models are unavailable for this metric. And same for visits and for some other metrics. And afterwards, you may think, okay, probably this is a limitation of the solution. And this is what I meant when I said that by default, it's not possible to apply an attribution model for the page views metric. However, there is a trick. The trick is the following. There is a metric which is called content velocity. Also, you may find page velocity metric. So for example, in my case, I already can see page velocity metric in my list. If you can't find these metrics in your menu, For example, I will look for velocity. And if you do not see either of these metrics, you will need to create a new project in Analysis Workspace and select, let me show you, a template. In the template, you need to look for content consumption web, and when you open this template, you will find the metric somewhere in the project, in the template project. But since I already have this metric, I will add this metric to my table. And why do you need to add it to your freeform table? Because this is again the only way how you can create a copy and afterwards configure the attribution model for page views metric. So I will right click and I will select, actually I can't select it here, so I will need just to regroup a little. So I will just add this metric to the metrics area, and now I can right click, and now I will go to create metric from selection. It's quite kind of similar to how we created a copy of the segment. I will go to calculated metric builder, and there you go. So now you can see how this metric is built, and here you can find page views with an attribution model. So now you can click on the gear icon and you can see that the checkbox is still grayed out. However, there is an edit link, and if you click on this link, you can select any type of attribution available as an attribution model capability within Analysis Workspace. And there you go. So you can set any type of attribution and then delete the components that you don't need for your calculated metric. And this is the way how you can set it up for page views. So now you can just name it the way you want, and you will have this metric available for your analysis. This is it for today. Hope you found this helpful. Also, if you want to know more tips of how to use Analysis Workspace, some, let's say, hidden opportunities for configuration and analysis, don't miss my other videos that you can find on the channel. And for today, this is it. Thank you for watching, and talk to you next time. Bye.